labs environments from various places. My topic is water and energy use efficiency of maize vis-a-vis paddy crop in Punjab agriculture. I move towards crop diversification next. So you know all the Punjab was a maize growing state. Now the area under paddy has increased. If you see the figures, it has increased from 3 lakh hectares to 30 lakh hectares. Whereas area from maize has declined from 5.5 lakh hectares to just 1.31 lakh hectares. And this is the story we all know. And but even this is story, we all know the paddy crop is highly water intensive crop. It takes approximately 10,000 cubic meters of water per hectare, whereas maize takes only 2,500 cubic meters of water per hectare. So paddy wheat crop rotation, no doubt, is posing certain problems. And we have out of we want all of this paddy wheat crop rotation. Maize is a very good alternative. Next, many have suggested this maize as an alternative, and Department of Agriculture is also in line to bring maize in this in Punjab again. Next, so in backdrop of this, my present study aims at resource use efficiency of maize vis-a-vis paddy. Next, in this I took a sample of 100 farmers and two districts, and the districts were chosen on the criteria that these districts have maximum maize area, so that I can get sample also. And I choose 25 farmers from each block, and 28 villages were chosen for this study, and 100 farmers were selected from 28 villages. From Garchankar, previous one, from Garchankar, Bangla, Shirinath, Kusab and Nurpur were the blocks. Next. And in this study, I went for resource use efficiency, that is crop plus production function, and then I compared the resource use efficiency by having MVP and MFC ratios, and then I went for the water productivity. Next. So water productivity was calculated by dividing the output with the water, that means grain yield with the water, to see how much water is consumed in producing these grains. Next, and the results and discussion. Next, for area under maize crop, if you see this slide, the 5.22 hectare area was average operation holding of sample farmers, in which 25% was under maize. So just 25% was under maize and rest was under the other crops. Next, if you see the cropping pattern among the sample farmers, overall paddy and maize, they dominated the cropping pattern, but paddy dominated with 28% area and 11% area was under maize. Next, in the rabi season, wheat, spring maize, green peas, they dominated the cropping pattern, and fodder was in both the seasons, rabi as well as wheat season, and it covered only 4-5% of the gross crop area. Next. I looked at the status of groundwater level of sample farmers in my study, and it was surprising that 10 years ago, that is in 2004, 76% of the farmers reported that their water level was below 20 meter depth, and now only 53% farmers reported in 2014-15 that their water level is below 20 meter. If you see the last figure, there was no farmer reported in my sample study whose water level depth is above 50 meter. Whereas 12% of farmers reported that in 2014-15 their water level depth is above 50 meter, which means 175 feet. Next, if I go for the comparative cost structure of maize vis-a-vis paddy, which was my objective, and then I found that no doubt maize saved your cost. Niche figure, but the maize saved 15,786 rupees per hectare. Maize saved 2,000 in fertilizers, near about 3,500 in human labor, in tractor use, 3,500 in tractor use, and near about 8,600 in labor, making a total of 15,000 savings in cost if you grow maize rather than paddy. No doubt the cost of seed is more in maize than in paddy, but because of hybrid seeds, otherwise there is a saving of cost if we grow maize. Next. Now if I go for return structure, because of the strong MSP, because of the infrastructure development, because of the government policies, and in that study in 2014-15, 1360 was the MSP of paddy, and but the price received by maize growers was only 1100 to 1000 to 1100 per quintal. Yes, and I chose those farmers only who grow maize as well as paddy on the same farm. Especially I went farmers who had the same maize and paddy in the same season, and that's why no doubt the returns are more in paddy, that is due to their price and due to their more yield. The returns of a variable cost in maize was 27,000, whereas in paddy was 38,000, so a difference of 10,000. Next. When I went for the cobblerless production function, the cobblerless production function clearly showed that the seed and the labor are the significant factors in the maize crop. Next. The ratio of MVP to MFC clearly meant that with the use of more seed, the returns could be increased because the ratio is 2.35, which means 1 unit increase in this ratio will, in the use of seed, will increase the net returns by 2.35. Next. Now, I went for purpose production function for paddy also, and then I saw that human labor, plant protection, DAP, urea, and water use are significant, and the more use of plant protection, urea, dia, and water use will increase the yield by 0.33%. Next.
Ma'am, we have we will have to compel our political leadership to deliver to the people, last place to the people. That is intellectual crucial. The intellectual people who are proven that 2 plus 2 is equal to 3 or 5, they are working for the government, they are working for the corporations, for petty gains, meaningless gains. We should get rid of those people. Only then, by developing pro-people, pro-nation economic model, we can come out of this problem and all other problems of the economy. Thank you very much. We are short of time, so this session is over.